We're going to pour in just a little bit to start, because we want to end up with it feeling a little bit like Play-Doh or like clay, not too runny, because we need to shape it. In fact, I may have put a little bit too much in already. So just put a little bit in to start and mix it. And you want it a little bit less sticky than I have it. And this to me is the fun part. All right, so is everybody doing okay? All right, so now what you'll do is you'll take a little tiny bit of the ball once you've got it all mixed up, and you're gonna roll it in your hands. So really you want something about the size of a dime. And I'm going to get a pie, just a regular tray from the oven. Anything will work, a board or anything, and I'm going to put it on there and it will sit there to dry. And there's my cat who's come to help. Are you going to drink the water? All right, so that's what we're doing. They don't need to be perfectly shaped and just enough to... You don't want them too big because then the seeds can't get out. So little small ones are the best way to go. Yes, like that. You can do, if you get tired, you can do this tomorrow. You can finish them later. There's a good amount of seeds and clay and compost in here. And these seeds are really wonderful seeds. So I'm gonna stop, you guys keep going. I'm gonna stop and tell you a little bit about the seeds. I'm gonna wash my hands off. All right, so there is a reason why native flowers are really, really important, and that is a lot of times they've been here a very long time before even people were, and there are bugs that can only live off a certain kind of flower. Like I think I wrote in my instructions, like a bee has to have flowers to get food, and then turns it spreads the bee pollen around so the plants can grow more plants. And the flowers are all set up to call for the bees to come visit them. Oops, get clay on me. They even evidently can see in the dark a little bit, and a lot of flowers will glow in the dark, so they know exactly where to go. So they have this great team. And that's true of many, many, many flowers and plants. They actually, there's some milkweeds that only, there's about 10 bugs, they can only live on the milkweed. And if they're gone, then they are not here either. They can't live. So, and then I'm gonna show you something else real interesting. This is a picture of a wildflower. Now, this is not in your mix, but this one is called, I made it really tall. This is called a gay feather. And it's really pink and pretty, and it looks like a feather, and they're almost this tall, but they take 2 years to grow under the ground before they even bloom. So it's not a popular flower because people don't want to wait 2 years. But the reason they do that is in Texas, as you know, our soil is really rocky and we have droughts. So the best thing that a plant can do is make really, really long roots to get down to the water that's way below. So this one plant, I'm gonna take it back up. This one plant will have roots. Now I'm unwinding, right? That go this long. They're still going. They go down underground 16 feet. And that's how they live through some of the really hot Texas dry weather, which I think is really impressive. All right, so how's everybody doing? Good, so working out? Roxanna, are they all muted? Maybe. Roxanna?
I will unmute everybody. Let's see if anyone wants to ask questions.
Okay. Lydia, how are you doing? No, she can't hear. Okay.
Okay, we're fine. I'm fine. I don't know what Ella's doing.
I don't either.
All right. Let's see. Is everybody else doing pretty well? Look at those wonderful dirty hands. All right, so after finishing your whole batch of, first, does anybody have any questions? Doing good? Okay. After you finish your whole batch of balls, then what you want to do is you want to let them dry for one day, at least one day, until they get good and hard. And they will get as hard as these guys, which I showed you in the beginning. So they're, you know, if I drop one, they're pretty hard. And then,
first, to put seeds in them.
The best trick of all is to throw them out before a good rain happens.
You already have seeds in there.
Because rain, instead of watering them,
the other seeds that were here.
Look, they're out here. Here we go.
Aren't they so familiar? There they are.
Okay, does anybody have any questions?
Wait, are we supposed to put this inside?
You what?
Are we supposed to put this inside those?
To dry?
Yeah.
Yes, you can put them inside to dry. Yeah.
We put the seeds inside, right?
Oh, yes, put the seeds inside, right.
Oh, yeah. You have to put the seeds, not mix again.
No. Yeah, it happens, yeah. Oh, look at that. Hi. Hi. All right. So you mix all the dry stuff together. And then you pour in just a little bit of water. It's really easy to put too much water in, so start with just a little bit. Oh yeah, those are on the tray. Ooh, those are looking good. So then the main thing again is to make sure that when you throw them out, that you have them in an area that won't be mowed. And preferably, that gets a lot of sun. They really do like sun a lot. And they'll start growing pretty soon. Right now, I haven't seen our blue bonnets come up yet. We have about 1,000 blue bonnets every year. I've been planting them for years and years and years. And you'll see sometime maybe October, November, the little tiny shoots come up. And you can look them up to see, make sure what they are. And then they'll kind of stay low and they'll grow through the rest of the winter. And then when spring, they'll do that. Well, they put a long root going down so that they have plenty of water. And then all of a sudden they'll explode when it comes to a spring. So it's a long growing season, but it's exciting. So, yeah. It's looking good. All right, well, I will let you guys just finish your work. If you have a question, ask me. And if not, I'll just leave you to making your seed balls. And make sure you help clean up. And
you might go for salt.
What?
Ooh, that's a good one.
Look at mine, as good as a basketball.
Yes. You in the blue shirt. What you want? What you
want? We were here a little late, so we don't really know how to do the project.
Okay. All right, I'll tell you real quick, and there's instructions. There should be instructions in there, but if not, you want to take a bowl and you mix all the dry things together. So you're going to mix your clay, which helps everything stick together.
Okay.
And you're going to mix the compost, which is the dirt, which is the food it grows on. And then you'll mix the seed. There's about a tablespoon of seeds in there.
Okay.
All together dry.
Okay.
Yeah. And we were just talking about these plants have to grow all winter long because they put roots down that go really, really deep.
Does it help, Didi?
How about
I can reach. We're good.
No.
Get the three things in there? Yeah. Get in there and get good. This is a good nerdy thing. And then once you get them all the dry stuff mixed up.
Oh, because it's compost.
Water in it?
A little bit of water in, just a little bit at a time, because it's really
the black is compost.
Yes. Black is compost.
You know, leaves and grass and
what?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, good. Good mixer. And then just a little bit of water. Yeah.
Right when you're rubbing it, to rub it over the bowl.
Is this enough? I think I'm out of dries.
If you're out, then you've made enough. Wash
them really tiny, like the size of a dime. And if you made them too big, just split them in two and make them a little bit smaller.
Can I make a big one? No, I think they're okay.
Sample?
What do you think?
Dried one? They're like this.
That is, okay.
Size of a dime?
They're a big.
It's a little bit big, but... you want to be, clay is really strong, and you want to be able to have the clay melt at some point and the seeds be able to sprout out of it. So,
okay.
Here's a wet one I made. I don't know if that helps. It looks just the same but wet. Put it over here. Yeah, there you go. So, here's what mine look like right now. And they're wet, and I'll just put them on a tray to dry. I'll probably put them outside in the sun.
Put your hands up.
She has this so far.
How many do you have?
Two.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh.
I'm gonna be in the dirt. Usually at the library we do this and everybody gets into a giant bucket and mixes everything up and gets really dirty. It's really fun.
Oh, that's
okay.
Yeah.
Wash my hands.
Barbara, while everybody's working, do you want to talk a little bit about October, November, and December
okay.
workshops coming up?
Okay. You might have to help me remember the order. In October. In October, we have, let me get back to my gallery.
Remember, you have to lean over here because see where the dirt is falling? We want to keep the dirt on the table where the towel is.
Okay.
I'm going to go ahead and mute everybody so we can, while you guys are working, Barbara's going to talk a little bit about upcoming workshops, and then I'll unmute everybody again if you have any other questions before we close this meeting. Okay?
Okay. So in October, we have, for kids, it's making Halloween soup, and I'm actually working on this right now. You buy these, in your kit will be these tiny, tiny, tiny little beads, and you soak them in water. I know you can't see this, but they come out as clear jelly beads, and they'll grow twice as big. They get pretty big, and then we're gonna just be do some fun things with them. We're gonna add food coloring and creepy, crawly spider things and insects so that people come over, you can stick your hand in them and you can, you know, get really lovely scared and creeped out. So it's just a fun one. And then in November,
we have the stenciled tea towels.
Tea towels. So we'll get kitchen towels and we have stencils and you just dab paint on the stencils and you can make some stencils are like, there's a rhinoceros, an elephant, and a giraffe. And so you can make towels, not unlike the one I have hanging in my kitchen, which has pictures on it. And it's very dirty because I just wiped my dirty hands on it. So that's good. That's actually good for Thanksgiving, if you're having Thanksgiving, because everybody needs towels to clean up. And then in December, we are having, we're making little snowy owls out of pine cones. Which actually we're going to Colorado and I'm bringing home some pine cones for everybody. And you wrap it in cotton and it looks just like a snowy owl. It's really, really fun, really easy fun. And that'll be for the holiday season. So.
I'm super excited about all of these fun programs coming up. Does anyone else have any questions for Barbara before we end this Zoom? I'm going to go ahead and allow everybody to unmute themselves. So if you have any last minute questions or comments.
All good?
No, everyone's good. You're going to keep making your seed balls and throw them out this week? Right before rain, right, Barbara?
Right before rain, yeah, right. All right. I know you're trying to unmute, aren't you? Yeah, it's hard with your elbow. That's a pretty good trick. You might have to get a pencil or something. All right, well, I'll let you guys go and keep doing this. It's a lot of fun. Let them dry, throw them out before it rains, and you will be doing a lot to help out the environment and all our wonderful insects, which are really having a hard time because there's not as many plants that they need to eat and live on as there used to be. So you guys are heroes. Yay. All right. Bye, everybody. Okay,
thank you, guys. Have a good afternoon, and maybe we'll see you next month for Halloween soup.
Yep.
Bye.
Bye-bye.